Number 5, the Frequencies Procedure. Okay, so here we're going to look at our first statistical analysis. And a very common analysis to run is the Frequencies Procedure. While frequencies can be run on any variable, it's most common to run them on categorical variables, variables that consist of a limited number of categories. And for those who are familiar with the scales of measurement, they typically make up a nominal scale of measurement. So we'll run frequencies on gender, since this is a categorical variable. People are either in the first or second category, male or female. So to do that, we're going to go ahead and select Analyze, and then Descriptive Statistics, and then Frequencies. And notice here the three variables that you see in the data view window are listed here on the left. We want to select gender, and then click the right arrow button to move it over to the right. And then go ahead and click OK. And now what happens is the viewer window opens here, and the output of this analysis of the frequencies table is shown. Our first table indicates that we have 10 valid values and 0 are missing. What that means is that we had a gender value reported on every single person. If, for example, one person, we didn't know if they were male or female, it wasn't recorded, then we would have had 9 here under valid and 1 under missing. Okay, to look at the results here, briefly, we have, this indicates the frequency, how many there are. We have 3 males, and we have 7 females. Males make up 30% of the data set, while females make up 70%. Number 6, the Descriptives Procedure. Now, another very common analysis is to run descriptive statistics using the Descriptives Procedure. And they're most often run on quantitative variables, or variables that consist of a number of different values where the numbers used communicate meaning about the variable. In other words, like these exam scores. The value of 80 indicates that performance, it's really a percentage in this case, but it indicates not only that they scored 80%, but we know that they did better than the person who scored 72, and so on. These quantitative variables are often consist of ratio or interval level data, and sometimes ordinal as well, if we're talking in terms of the scales of measurement. So to run descriptives, we want to go to Analyze, and then Descriptive Statistics, followed by Descriptives. And here we're going to select Exam 1 and Exam 2, and I can select both by pressing and holding on the Ctrl key. Click the right arrow button to move them over, and then click OK. And now our output or viewer window opens again, and here we have our table of output. Notice we have Exam 1 in the first row, followed by Exam 2. The lowest score, as indicated by the minimum on Exam 1, was a 57, and a 98 was the highest score. For Exam 2, the lowest score was 60, and 98 was the highest on Exam 2 as well. Next, we have the mean reported, and notice that the performance on Exam 2 was slightly better than Exam 1, as indicated by the mean, or the arithmetic average. And the standard deviation, a measure of variability, shows that the scores on Exam 1 were slightly more variable or spread out than were the scores on Exam 2, although these two measures are really fairly close. Number 7, correlation. Correlations are a very commonly run procedure in SPSS, so let's go ahead and take a look at those as well. So to run correlation, we want to go to Analyze, and then Correlate, and then select Bivariate. Now here we're going to run a correlation on Exam 1 and Exam 2. Correlations always require 2 variables at a minimum. And what we're going to measure here with the correlation is there a relationship between the scores on Exam 1 and Exam 2? For example, do people who do well on Exam 1 also tend to do well on Exam 2? And do people who do poorly on Exam 1 also tend to do poorly on Exam 2? If that's true, then we should see a positive correlation here. So let's go ahead and run this analysis and see what we get. So we want to select both Exam 1 and Exam 2 variables, and we can do that by pressing and holding the Ctrl key once again. Go ahead and click the right arrow button, and then click OK. And now we get the results of the correlational analysis here, and in this table, we look where Exam 1 and Exam 2 intersect or meet, and it's redundant. These values here are the same as these values here. But notice that the correlation here is 0.819, or about 0.82 if we round to two decimal places. This indicates that there's a strong positive relationship between the two exam scores, meaning that people who score high on exam 1 tend to score high on exam 2 as well. People who score low on exam 1 tend to score low on exam 2. I can get back to my output by selecting Window, Output. And that this relationship is quite strong, as the highest correlation you can have when it's positive is 1.0. And in this video, we'll go ahead and skip interpreting this significance or p-value, as we have other resources where we dive into that in detail.